Next one, hips equals power. Incorrect. People think sometimes if I use my hips, I get power. That's not correct. Hips is a plural term. You've got left and a right. So it's about knowing their roles. A good football team, well, you look at a good AFL team. The Western Bulldogs, they won last year. They beat this really awesome team, the Swans, in the grand final. But they're not the best team on paper. But everyone plays their role. Everyone knows their role. And a good soccer team sometimes. You know, Australia did really good in the World Cup a few years ago when we only lost to Italy because they cheated. But we weren't the best. Our team on paper was worth about $50 and the Italian team was worth about $250 million. And somehow we were competitive the whole game because everyone knows their role. And that's important as opposed to just having a star player all the time.
Right.
So what happens, you've got a left and a right. People think, I'm using my hips, I must have power. No, you don't. It's like sort of saying like this, I'm using my hips, yes? But what direction is my left hip going? Back. 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 So I'm using my hips like this, which seems to think that would contribute to power that way. Torque versus traction pushes off, but it's not necessarily because physics says you're sending energy that way to try to send energy this way. So you've got to understand each hip has to have a role and it has to know its role. So if I'm in Hanmi just means 45 degrees, and I want to get the shomen. Shomen just means face to front. Anyone ever heard of shomeni, right?
Aye.
Shomen, front, knee, face, shomeni, face to front, right? Otagani, otagai, everyone, otagai, everyone, knee, face everyone, right? So, hanmi to shomen, then it's not about pulling my hips. See how my left hip's going backwards?
Aye.
So again, I see this in empi all the time. I see it in second kata all the time. This left hip, oh, I'm demonstrating really badly today, I apologize. This left hip's going backwards. You're losing power.
Right.
Again, when I see, you know, second cues do MP and I see that, I'm like, oh, forgive that. When I see a second arm do that in MP, it's like, bleh. Like, come on, like, you want, that's really important.
Right.
That's really important. The right hip knows its role. My role is to go forward. That gives the right hand power to go forward. Like when I have a bow and arrow, I don't hold the bow and I don't hold the string and let the other bit go. I hold that in place and let the string go. I don't know the archery term, so I don't know if that's called the string. Okay, but I let this go, not that go. So it's the same. This holds its place. Its role is to stand firm. I'm not moving anywhere. If anything, its role is just to, like Sun Chin, just to edge forward an inch. Boom. And the right hip, oh God. The right hip has a role. So when we're in a short stance, these hip tremors working in sync, gamaku, adds power. Because it's a short and it's just like, boom, boom. It's creating a small tremor. The small circle drives the big circle, it gives power. When you're in hanmi, so anytime you're 45 and you want to use your hips, like a fighting stance is 45, or there's many blocks in kata where we're like this. Empi is another example there. When the left hip goes back, da-dong, you're losing all your power. Each side, left and right, has to know its role. And when does that other one push? You know, you'll see Basai here, hips square up, block. Power on my prep. Why do I need power on my prep? No power on my block. But isn't that when I want power? So the left hip doesn't move back, the right hip, oh, sorry about this, the right hip should move forward. But when does the right hip move forward? Now, when it wants to, when it wants the strength behind it. Hey? Step by is the same, you'll see this. See that? And now there's no hip in this. So one, and this is common in step by as well, by the way. It's the circle that stops. Versus circle never stops. I don't need power here. I just want to do a small sotuke as I prep. And then renuke as I, and now is when I want. Sorry, very little movement today. Now is when I want power. Hey? I just want you to, again, go away for a few minutes. Think of when am I working from hanmi to shomen, and then how am I using my hips? Because if you don't think about that and make changes, you're just reinforcing bad habits. And then, especially if you're an instructor, monkey see, monkey do, your students look at that and go, oh, okay, and then you've got students going like this in kumite. Losing reach, losing power. And you've got students doing this in kata. Losing reach, losing power, versus pushing into what you're doing. And again, that's why sometimes you'll see, I'm not Zach doesn't do this, by the way. But sometimes you'll see someone in kata and go, whoa, like Ryan, he rolls really quick in kata. You watch them in kata and go, whoa, that's fast. And not those guys, by the way. But you watch them and go, whoa, that's fast. But there's something that doesn't look right. Ah, that's what it is. They're sending energy in the wrong direction. It's speed with a complete compromise of physics.
Okay.
It doesn't get the tick of approval from the physics professor who's standing out the front going, I'm a physics professor. And that, no, that doesn't make any sense at all.
Okay.
And I pointed this out to someone before as well. All stances, natural posture, apart from sun chin. So here's my natural posture. Sun chin, I move my buttock in an inch. I can't do it because I have my back. I move it in an inch. But here's my natural posture, yes?
Okay.
Cat stance, natural posture. Zen Kutsudach, natural posture. Sumo, not this. Okay, I can't do it. You see that in sumo sometimes? Natural posture. Zen Kutsudach, back stance. Every stance, natural posture.
Okay.
So don't suck the bum in. Because sometimes that's sucking the backside in kills your movement in your hips because it's contracting all the muscles around it. And it's also impacting your strength because I'm most strong when I'm in my natural posture. So karate is about working from natural postures. So that's important as well to keep in mind. The Kankurai example where someone's like this and you see it all the time. And if I was to stand up, that's the posture. See how that's not my natural posture?
Hey.
Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Again, I can't do it. But if I'm here, that's my natural posture. So always work within the framework of your natural posture.
Hey.
That's not my natural posture. Not my natural posture. So when you're working with your hips, when this happens, this tends to happen. More so in guys, because we just have a natural incline to want to use our arms. I'm being sexist, because not every guy's like that, not every woman's like that. But generally, it's a guy thing to be sort of up here. And that's why, honestly, I prefer watching the girls do kata because I think it often looks neater, cleaner, just maybe the guys have more explosion, but again, what's the point of being explosive if it looks like it's not going to hurt Brock Lesnar? So, oh, that looks really good. It wouldn't hurt someone bigger than you, so what's the point? Hey? So, work on any hip movement. When do I move my hips and what's it doing to my posture? Hey, a couple of minutes, go.